Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. This is the strangest email I've ever gotten. This is from Sarah. Sarah's on the cattle farm in England. And Sarah's on the podcast before. I answered one of her questions. And as a thank you, they've now named one of the new cattle after me. Is that the weirdest thank you you've ever had? Somewhere right now in England, there's a head of cattle that is named after me. So Sarah sent in an insanely hard question, and this comes directly from Excel Gurus Gone Wild. I'm going to try and explain this. These are vehicles here, and this is the mileage when the vehicle was fueled. And Sarah says, when they enter this vehicle and the mileage, she would like to go grab the previous mileage. So that involves finding the last entry for that vehicle and bringing that mileage down to here. Right now, they're doing that completely manually. And I have a formula that will do this, but I need to explain what's going on, even if it's just for my own personal trying to understand how it works. First of all, I want to talk about match. Now, match is kind of like VLOOKUP, but not the VLOOKUP or match that we usually do with comma false. This is the exact match. The exact match says, hey, the data over here is sorted, and we want to find a match for 952. And 952 says that that is in the 15th row of the range, right? That works out great. Now, I want to show you a cool trick here. What if we ask for a number that's way larger than any of the numbers? So just I'm going to put in a bunch of nines. That always is going to return the last cell in the range. Cool trick, isn't it? Now, I'm going to make this a little bit more interesting. I'm going to replace some of these numbers with NAs. So equal NA. And strangely enough, the match ignores those NAs and tells me the last real number in the range. Got it? All right, now you're saying, well, how is this going to solve our problem? I'm going to come back here to our spreadsheet, and I've built an interesting formula. It says, hey, we're going to use the match of a really large number, 99999, and then on the fly, I'm going to build a new array. Check to see if everything from $C$1 down to the row right above me, C21, and notice there's no dollar sign there before the 21, is equal to C22. If it is, put in the number 1. If it's not, put in the number NA. And so let's conceptualize what we're going to get here. We're going to get an array of either 1s or NAs. There'll be a 1 here, NA, 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 a 1, NA, 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 and so on. And then I'm using that match trick. Look for a really large number within that array. And the array is going to be either 1s or NAs. It's going to tell me the position of the last matching number. You have to use Control Shift Enter because it's an array formula. That tells me that on row 16 is the last C123 ABC. All right, so now that I know that, I'm going to come back here and I'm going to use the index function and say the index of all of my fuel values in C, in looks like a column G, column G. So G1, G$1 to G22. And which row number do I want? I want the result of that match. Put the closing parentheses, Control Shift Enter, and 28331. Now we'll copy this up and just see how it matches what Sarah had manually done. And as I go through, it looks like, hey, look at that, it's working. All right, just an insanely hard formula. Now this NA is saying that this particular vehicle, V83HDL, has not been fueled in this data set. Sarah's going to have to deal with those herself. So there you have it. An insanely hard formula. That's straight out of Excel Gurus Gone Wild, the book of some of the best amazing formulas that came out of the Mr. Excel message board. I want to thank Sarah for sending that question in. You know, last time I answered a question, I had a cattle named after me. I really have no idea what the follow-up will be, but very cool. I want a picture. I don't know why. And here's this. Oh, never mind. It's completely insane. All right. Want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.